It would have been something that would have been temporary. Matter of fact, what they would do is that they would get what they would call a warrant, which means that they had a right to go out and look for land. Then they had to survey it, and they had to mark it off, survey it, and they also had to build some kind of, even in the description, it uses the word shack. So let's say that they don't require like the best, biggest and best house. So you can build a shack like this or a cabin, and then you have to, basically they would usually clear at least an acre of land and plant corn there, which was an easy crop. And so once they did that, they could mark things off, then they could have somebody survey it, then they would have to go back and register it. But that ended up with a lot of conflict, because for decades, maybe longer, there were court cases from these people that had overlapping claims. So it may even continue to this day. So anyway, you can see how that could happen, where somebody could come and mark their trees and somebody else could mark their trees, and then they both go back and then, wait a minute, I was there first. So what we have here is we have a dirt floor, so we decided to go with the basics. We did not build a chimney, but that was one of the things we thought of. But what we did was we actually took some of the big field stones that we found here in this area, and we ended up making a little fireplace back there, and the smoke just comes out the top. And so it looks like the cabin is on fire, but when we have demonstrations, we go ahead and start a little fire in there. And we have, on Founders Day, we have this little meadow filled up. We have people here doing all kinds of demonstration, blacksmith, kids can shoot bow and arrow. We have people here skinning hides or cooking, making butter, just doing all kinds of stuff. And so we fill this place with people doing demonstrations, and we shoot the. I was thinking about bringing my flintlock long rifle today, and I didn't. But feel free to come in here and look around. It needs a little bit of maintenance now, but it's held up pretty well. We were able to get some they call these shakes or shingles, and we researched the type of notches that you would make for this type of early cabin. You see how we basically put rock down here to put our first logs on the corners, and then we put more rocks under here to keep maybe animals or small children from climbing in and out. During the winter, you would put wedges of wood or rocks in here, and then you would pack mud or manure and grasses and stuff in there. You would pack that in there, and then that would keep the breezes from blowing through. And then in the spring, you would knock it out so you could get your breezes. Does anybody have any questions about anything that we talked about?
What's a punch?
Huh?
What is a punch?
Punch in? I didn't use the word punch in.
It was first log, I think, on the bottom of the cabin.
Mm-hmm. So there is a certain order that you need to do this, and it just naturally settles. And so, we keep an eye on it to make sure that it's not falling over or anything like that. One time after like a few months, the park manager came and said, "Hey, it's starting to tilt a little bit." And I looked at it and thought, well, it's fine. It's just naturally settling. So this gives you an example of what the early or first log cabin in Fayette County would have looked like. So we do have thoughts of maybe, even putting some kind of stone house or log house, which would be bigger and more permanent, maybe over here. But for now, this was enough. We did have a what we call a half-faced shelter, which would be the step before this. It'd be like a half a log cabin that you could build in, and basically it would take two or three hours, and it would be a shelter that you would use for a couple weeks or a month. The first one that the scouts built fell down, and then we built another one, and then that collapsed, and then they put something else there. So we were meaning to put that back, so we had that progression. Any other questions? This is what you would have. So We talked about the streams, and they would use them for power. And so you have the wheel, and it would turn, and then it would be hooked up to something like this, and then that would grind. You could grind grain, and so you have gunpowder mills. You have grain mills, and so that those were, and they called those engines. Mm-hmm. And so those were the early engines, and so that's what that is.
Where did the millstones come
from? The ground. You tell me.
Over in Western Woodford County.
Over in Western Woodford County, yeah. But that is where they actually, a lot of times, you know, we all do this. We'll be driving along, and then we'll be like, I smell caves around here somewhere. You start seeing, you know, places like this and no stream running out. You say, there's caves around here somewhere. I do that to my wife and say, there's caves around here somewhere. And then, you know, like it in about 10 minutes, we'll see some sign that'll say something about caves or something. She says, you're right, how'd you know that? But anyway, you'll say, there's a cave, and you look at it closer, and it's like, well, that's kind of weird. It looks like a cave that goes nowhere. So what they've done is they've actually cut out a section of the hill that has a limestone in it, and so then they will use those stones and cut them to make these stone houses. And they kind of look like some kind of cave or rock shelter or something like that, but it's kind of weird. So when you see something like that, so we actually have, you know, a spot or two out here which has that. So, all right. Thank you all for coming to McConnell Springs. Let me know if you have any other questions about the district.
Thank you so much.
John.
You're welcome.
I really appreciate it.
You're welcome.
It was awesome.
Thank you.
All right. We've got to get back. I'm so sorry. It's super awesome.
Go ahead.
So this would be the primitive cabin. And so you have a place where we have built fires in here, and we can build a fairly good sized fire, and the smoke comes up here, and if you stay low, it just goes out. But basically this would be a place where you could kind of fortify things a little bit. And you might have a guard wandering around, but people could sleep in here and stay warm without worrying that somebody's going to sneak up on them and shoot them or something like that, like you would in the open. So basically this was a temporary cabin that, you know, settlers, you know, maybe hunters or surveyors, but a lot of times it would be a family would build something like this, and for the first year, and then while they're doing this, they're working on their crops, and then they will start building a more permanent house.
Okay, well, my one question would be about this. In schools, in teaching in Kentucky for almost 30 years, yeah. The cabin you always hear about is the Lincoln cabin. Uh-huh. And is that an example in its time of something like this or an advancement?
Okay, so my mother explained it to me once. She said the difference between a log cabin and a log house is the log house would be more permanent. So you can see we have dirt floors. You could or may not have a chimney, but you know, you see this is primitive. We have round logs, we have no floor, it's not very big. So when you build the second one, that would be what you would call the house. The cabin is something just more primitive in Ireland or in here. The house would probably have wooden floors, it would have a chimney, it might have a couple stories, it would be bigger, it would have something that people would like to live in for some period of time.
And I didn't realize it, you know, you're looking at this overall, and I didn't realize it's not hand-hewn logs. It's
no,
just round. It's just.
Yes, we took the bark off because if you leave the bark on, the bugs get in it.
Correct.
But you can see, I mean, this has been here since 2013.
But they're just logs. They're not axed.
As long as they stay dry,
yeah.
They're pretty good. Yeah.
So as to the notching that you did, you mentioned you researched it and said this was the type. Now, I know the dovetails and other
right,
stuff.
There were a couple different types of notches that we found that would be early on.
Okay.
And so we looked at those, and then we did kind of our own, a little bit of a variation on it. But basically, this would have been a type of notch that would have been used in the 1770s or 1780s. There were some that were invented later on, probably more in association with, you know, the huge log houses that you're talking about.
Correct. Okay. Well, that is
so we
nice
tried
to see.
See, the interesting thing is there are a lot of variations on styles that you can use.
Yes, there are. Well, I thank you very much, and I wanted to add that after he finished. Thank you.